In this video, I'm going to talk about 13 transactions. And for each transaction, I want to identify the two accounts involved, and then I want to identify the two effects that there will be on the accounting equation. So the first one is purchase supplies with cash. The two accounts in this transaction are easy to identify. We have supplies and cash. And these are both assets. Supplies will go up and cash will go down. The next transaction is similar. We're going to buy insurance. Paid 6 months of insurance in advance. When we pay multiple months of insurance, we will use the prepaid insurance account, which is an asset. And we will be paying cash. So those are the two accounts involved, prepaid insurance and cash. Prepaid insurance will go up and cash will go down, and they are both assets. We're starting off easy because this third transaction is the same as the first two. We're paying rent for 12 months in advance, so we will use the account called prepaid rent, which is an asset account. And we will pay cash. So prepaid rent will go up and cash will go down. Now, this one's a little different. We're going to buy inventory on account. Whenever I say on account, I mean either accounts receivable or accounts payable. And by the context, you should know. We're buying inventory, so we're going to be paying, and that's accounts payable. So inventory is an asset and it will go up. We're buying it on account, which means we're not paying now, so we will owe. Our liabilities will go up. Paid on account. Remember in the last transaction, we purchased inventory on account. Well, a week later, we're going to pay on account. So we're paying cash, cash goes down. And we're paying off our account payable, so the balance of our account payable will go down. Liabilities go down. Number six, issued common stock. Whenever we issue stock, we receive cash. So cash goes up and common stock goes up. Common stock represents a percentage of ownership. Number seven, we're going to pay a dividend. We're paying cash, so cash goes down. Cash is an asset. And dividends goes up. This seems wrong. It seems like we should have a negative sign on both sides of the equals sign. Well, think of it this way. Think of adding a number to the dividends list and see the negative sign up above. At the end of the year, we'll do closing entries and we will subtract that number at the end of the year. But during the year, we just add it to the list and we subtract it later. So you can feel comfortable that the equation will eventually balance. Number eight, we received cash that we have not earned. Sometimes we do receive cash before we earn it. For example, if we are an NFL football team and somebody pays us for season tickets. Well, we cannot say that we've earned the money until after we've played each game. So in the meantime, we have cash, so assets go up, but on the books, we're going to show that we owe a refund until we play the game. So we will put this in an account called unearned revenue, and that's a liability. And that means we owe a refund unless we play the game. Paid wages. We're paying with cash, so cash goes down, assets go down. And this is wages expense or salaries expense. It is an expense. Expenses go up, but this is another one of those strange ones. It goes up for now. Think of it like we're adding it to a list of expenses that will be subtracted at the end of the year in the closing process. So the equation does balance. or will balance. Oh, this is the hardest one of the 13. It's also the most common transaction in the world. There's four numbers here. When you sell inventory, there's two parts. There's the part where the customer gives cash to the cash register, and there's the other part where we record inventory that leaves the store. Cash goes up at the register, and sales goes up at the register. Part two, inventory is subtracted, and it's moved over to expense. The cost of goods sold represents inventory that has left the store. Earned cash. That means I finished a job and I immediately received cash. Cash goes up and revenue goes up. It's also possible to earn on account. This means that I finished my job, but my customer hasn't paid me yet, but promises to pay me later. That would be accounts receivable. Accounts receivable is an asset, and accounts receivable or assets goes up and revenue goes up. Received cash on account. If a customer owes us money and eventually pays us, we would have more cash and we would cancel the account receivable. So cash goes up and accounts receivable goes down.